Certified Inspiration, Julia here. Today I'm going to share the three signs that you're going to be good at violin. And with good, I mean that you are going to be able to impress your family and friends when you play for them. And the first sign is that you have a regular practice routine. This of course sounds like a no-brainer, but what is important about this routine is that you try to practice every day. So the regularity is not like once a week or once in 2 weeks, and then 2 hours at a time, but the best is just to practice 10 minutes a day, or maybe more if you have time for it. So it's better to practice a little bit every day than to practice a lot on one day and not practice at all on other days. The second sign that you're going to be good at violin is that you practice consciously. What do I mean with practicing consciously? I mean that if you're practicing and if you make a mistake, you are not starting from the beginning again and playing the song again until you make the mistake and start from the beginning again. No, you take the mistake out and you say, okay, this part doesn't sound good yet and I'm going to improve it yet. I'm going to show an example for you how you could do that. Was a mistake. So what you're not going to do is to start again and hope that the second time you won't make the mistake. And of course you will make the mistake again. So this happens with my students all the time and I can't stress enough, don't start from the beginning again. Start on the point where you made the mistake. So what you could do instead is go to this part and practice it really slowly. First just the notes, and then add the bowing, you could try different rhythms, just do anything that keeps you interested enough to play this part for so many times that you won't make any mistakes again. Another thing that if you are practicing, make sure to not make mistakes in the first place. Try to play so slowly that you are not making that many mistakes at all, so you won't learn the mistakes. The third sign that you're going to be good at violin is something I see with my students. I have some students that would just play on if they make a mistake, and other students, they improve themselves right away. And with this part, I'm mainly talking about intonation. So, for instance, if you make a mistake in intonation, that doesn't sound very good. So, if you make a mistake in intonation, the students that move on fastest directly improve their intonation. They don't just play on. No, instead they play. So instead they slide towards the right note instead of just hearing that the note doesn't sound good, but just sticking with it because you played it in the first place. And with this comes one very important skill, and that is listening very well to yourself. And this is both important for conscious practicing and for playing in tune and improving your intonation right away when you play. It is so important to at all times listen at yourself and be really critical of yourself actually, but not in a harsh way, not by like, oh, you sound so bad, that won't help you at all, but just to be really critical listening and hearing if you hear anything that could be improved and trying to think about how you can improve it. So really listen to yourself while you play. And maybe this sounds like, this is logical, right? Of course you listen to yourself when you play. But I have so many students that on the moment they start playing, they are so busy with their right bow hold and their right hand hold and everything that they forget to listen when they play. And you have to know that listening always comes at the first place, above anything else. So I hope these little tips helped you. And before I leave, I have one more tip. If you find it very hard to listen to yourself while you play, just get a camera of your phone or maybe of your webcam and record yourself while you play and listen back to it afterwards. So you can actually check yourself for mistakes and check which parts you should probably practice a little bit more often. You can color those parts in your sheet music and then you just work on those parts until they improved. So that are the three signs that you're going to be good at violin. And I hope if you didn't do any of these things yet, that you're going to do it right now so you will be good at violin and impress your friends and family soon. I wish you a very beautiful day and I hope to see you back on my channel for more violin inspiration, violin tutorials and everything else. See you!